Yes, guys, and we are back. Episode 7 of the Malaga Career Mode. It is the end of Season 4 today, so let's get into the video. Welcome back, lads. I hope you're enjoying the video so far. Much quicker turnaround this time. I'm quite into this series now. If you are new around here, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. We're on the road to 1,000 subs this year. We're getting closer and closer every single day. We're wicked if you come on that journey. So picking up where we left off in the last video, we are sat in 7th. The hunt for European football is very much on the cards this season. But, of course, we've still got a long way to go before we get there. Now, if we're going to get European football this season, we've got to have a minute to talk about some of the players. This front three that we've had this season, switching to a back five, Riley Brooks has been phenomenal. Absolutely top class. He's only 18 years old. The sky is the limit for this boy. Getting goals and assists. Absolutely loving playing out on the right wing. It's not just about the attackers, however. Marco Barella, the centre-back, Mexican. He's come into the back five this season. He's replaced Ramos, one of our day ones. He has been absolutely different gravy at the back. He's only 18 as well. Could be the future centre-back to replace Calero when he gets a bit older. As well as that, another defender who's worth a shout. I've already mentioned him before. It's Elliot Austin, the Australian left-back. Needs to get his weak foot up to 5 stars, but he has been absolutely brilliant. He got injured for it in the last video, but he's now fully fit again, and he's keeping Abdullah out of the side. Before we get into the first run of league highlights, first 4 games coming up, moment to take about the contracts. Harvey Elliott and Rodrigo are basically the only 2 players on top tier wages. Everyone else is basically getting paid absolutely peanuts. So something worth considering that at some point, they're going to have to start giving out new big contracts to everyone. I mean, Rari Yasuda, he's nearly 80 overall. He's on 6k a week. Something to keep an eye on as the season goes on. So lads, time to get into our first run of league highlights. 4 games coming up. Without further ado, let's get into it. So lads, here we are. Match day 1 of this first run of highlights, playing against Real Sociedad. They've got Julian Brandt and Diogo Jota. They're absolutely flying this season. Did not expect us to get a counter-attack inside the first 20 minutes. Harvey Elliott, through on goal here. Thinks about shooting. Ends up laying off to Rodrigo. A very weird goal. Very, very strange. But we'll take it. No complaints this side. We ended up holding that lead all the way through to the 68th minute. Sociedad on a counter-attack here. It's Jota through on goal. Figuera, phenomenal stop. After that chance, I realised, alright, time for a tactical change. Going to bring on big Josh Johnson and Damien. Go to a 5-2-3. Just try and grind out the result here. But unfortunately, not every tactical change that we make in games always pays off. All we did was invite more pressure on in the game. And Julian Brandt went and grabbed himself a brace to secure all of the points. Hey look, got to hold my hands up, alright? Can't get them all right. So after that disappointing loss, now we're playing against Elche at home. I gave Claudio Martino, the right back, his debut in this one. Young Italian fullback, see what he's about. First 3 minutes, he had a great opportunity to get a goal on his debut, but that there, absolutely shocking miss. Probably going to have to loan him out because that's just not good enough. Anyway, next attack, Riley Brooks and Harvey Elliott ended up showing him what he should have done, got the ball into the back of the net. And then moments later, Riley Brooks sets up Elliott, little reverse there, makes it 2-0. This game was end-to-end stuff. Next attack, Daniel Varin, Elche grabbed one back, but Ryo Suda had other ideas. Rodrigo slips him in here, one of his first and runs into the box, makes it 3-1. We are in complete cruise control at this point. Going into the second half, the game just descended into madness. Elche grabbed one more, but then we went into 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th gear. Lads, it was 6-2 in the end. So after that tactical mishap in the last game, for a poor substitution, changing the formation, this game, everything went to plan perfectly. All 3 of the subs were involved in the goals. Goros Arbel, Damien, and Gabriel Valente all pitching in. There you go, look, some you win, some you lose. That there, perfect example of how to manage a game properly. Match day 3, after one of the best performances of the season, we then had one of the worst performances of the entire series. We got humbled by Barcelona, brought crashing back down to earth. I mean, Delit, how is Delit getting a goal and an assist against us? Absolutely shocking. Those teams above us in the league, Barcelona, Real Madrid, Atletico, and Sevilla, and Sociedad as well. It's like a little mini league that we can't quite break into. The teams below us, we're absolutely battering. This one against Betis, 3-0 up in the first half. Still not over yet. Riley Brooks, once again, through and on goal. We've got Harvey Elliott at the back post. We've seen this time and time again. 4-0 in the first 45. Blowing away the teams. Figuera worked hard for his clean sheet, which he ended up getting. And then Rodrigo got another one to make it 5-0. So lads, that's everything for these first 4 games, that first one of the highlights. Let's take a break, let's take a breather, because now it's time for some big, big transfer news. So lads, transfer news. Spurs have come calling for Gabriel Valente, 4.4 mil release clause. I mean, I don't know why that clause is so small. Need to address that. Now, I'll be honest, he's not in the team at the minute, but he's only 20 years old. He's got a big, bright future ahead of him. So, of course, we're going to go into negotiations, try and offer him a new contract, persuade him to stay. Playing at Malaga is where I see him doing his best work. I don't want him going to Spurs. I want to keep a hold of him. Went into the negotiations, had to bump that release clause up to 18.6 mil. 2-year extension, and basically tripled his wages. But at this point, all we can do is just hope and pray that that's enough to keep him in a Malaga shirt. Luckily, the lad believes in the project that we're building here, and that he did turn down Spurs, which I'm very, very happy about. So after giving Valente a new contract, it only seemed right that for the next game, we throw him into the starting 11. See if he can repay some of that faith that we've shown in him. Next game, playing against Chicken Mayo, Rayo Vallecano. Matchday number 19, it took him 6 minutes to reward that faith with a goal. It's only attacking, but nonetheless, look what it means to the boy. One of our day ones, he had a great first season, kind of falling away a little bit out of the starting 11, but back in the goals. Obviously, he's playing a bit part role this season, 1-0. In this game against Rayo Vallecano, it was a very, very scrappy game. We should have been level just over the hour mark. This effort here, I don't know how he's missed the target. Absolute gift. And then Elliot Austin, that Australian left-back, playing in centre-mid for some reason. Don't know what he's doing there. Wins the ball. Harvey Elliott sees him continuing his run. Gets into the box. Gets his first goal for the club. He's took that like an absolute legend. Like a natural finisher. Brilliant stuff. 2-0. Another clean sheet. On we go. Up next, on the road again, playing against Valencia. As you can see, Valencia kept his place in the starting lineup. Inside the first 4 minutes, look at Rodrigo. Look, so much confidence. So much disrespect against Valencia. Dropping Rabonas. Deserved the goal, that one. Unfortunately, this game was not a game to be proud of. Found ourselves 1-0 down. 26 minutes on the clock. Big tackle there by Austin. Falls to Rodrigo. He makes this look so easy. So easy. Just absolute class finish. But Manuel Figueroa has been so solid this season. Gets lobbed from outside the edge of the box there. And then 8 minutes to go, just beating it his near post. Massive sign of weakness there. Not ideal. Suffer another loss. Next game at home, playing against Osasuna. Harvey Elliott, great start there inside the first 7 minutes. Found ourselves 1-1 just over the half hour mark. But then one day, big tackle there, plays it to Harvey Elliott. You can see the runner, it's Rodrigo. Got a defender and the goalie to beat. No bother. Bangs it into the back of the net, puts us back in front. So with not much time left, I made a triple sub. On comes Oscar Riviera, the Argentinian striker. See what he's about. He's played a little bit here and there. Did not expect him, with his first moment of this game, to spin the defender and whip in this beautiful finish shot 25 yards out. This game finished 3-2, so that was actually the winner. Makes that goal 10 times as good. In the next game, playing against this Alavaz team again. 2-0 up, very reminiscent of last season. Drop throwing away a lead out of nowhere. Look, Figueroa beating it his near post again. So, super sub Riviera brought him on for the last few seconds of this game. Can he secure the 3 points? You bet he bloody can. So, lads, it's everything for these weather highlights. Take a break. Let's see how we're getting on in the league. So lads, 8 games later, we are now in 6th. We're now into a European spot. 4 points behind Barcelona. As you can see, the teams above us are the teams we are losing against. Everyone below us, I think we're more than better than all of them. Only lost 6 games, conceded 31. It's just massive, massive improvements from where we were this time last season. Also worth mentioning, for the 4th season running, we failed to get past the round of 32 in the Copa del Rey. Don't want to talk about it. Next season, we will attack it properly. But just this season, it's all about this league finish. It's all about that league position we can finish in. So lots of transfer news now in this break. We've got 4 players going out on loan at the start of next season. Gorosabel, that lanky centre mid, he's going to go out for 1 year loan to Levante. Hopefully he gets some game time. As well as that, Josh Johnson, he's been in a bit of a decline the past 2 seasons, I'll be honest. Big 6'4" striker, get 2 year loan to Anderlecht. As well as that, Damien, we're going to loan him out for 2 years as well. He needs to get a lot of game time because there is a player there, but I can't put him into starting 11 at the minute. And as well as that, Gabriel Valente, he is getting his move to the Premier League. We'll be going and joining up with Sean Dyche. Hopefully he can learn how to defend a bit better. Now, we've got 2 more massive bits of transfer news in terms of players going out at the end of this season. I want to take a minute to talk about the rules, just to refresh your mind. Obviously, all of our players are from the academy, IRL, from the youth academy. However, one of these rules, in terms of transfer fees coming in from Real Madrid, Barcelona or Atletico, hasn't happened yet in this series. Halfway through season 4, it's finally happened. Xavi has pulled me into the office. 165 million has been offered for Harvey Elliott. We knew this day was coming. There was not a chance we were going to keep an 88 overall player in our squad. So that means that he is gone. We're going to have 145 mil in the bank for next season to try and reinvest in the squad and replace his goals and assists. Had it from day one, it's a very sad day, but he will play every minute of every game until we lose him. However, that wasn't the only bit of transfer news. There was one more significant bit of transfer news that was a massive mistake on my part. I ended up skipping through the emails a little bit too quick. And Roma, the club that wanted us to join them, have now come for calling for Rayo Yasuda. 46.8 mil release clause has been triggered. And unfortunately, I didn't have enough time to go into the contract negotiations. So he's going to be going as well. So that means we've now got 180 million in the bank for next season to reinvest. 2 massive players leaving us. That is going to be a massive issue. But we'll get to that at the end of the season in terms of who we're going to replace them with. So while all that transfer news was going on, we did have 5 more games, got battered against Atletico, and then we went on a 4-game unbeaten run. So going into the run-in for the league season, do we have enough form? Do we have enough about us, especially with these transfers going out, to get us a European spot? Well, time to cue the music. Getting to our last run of league highlights. Here we are then, lads. Last run of league highlights. As you can see, Pedro Azevedo has come into the starting 11. I've dropped Rayo Yasuda. I don't see the point in playing him anymore. I don't want to develop him any further because he's leaving. Harvey Elliott, however, as I said, he will play every minute of every game because he can do things like that. Just unreal. Creates goals all by himself. This game finished 2-0. Was a very, very nervy game, but another clean sheet, another 3 points, and we go. Playing against Cadiz next, Harvey Elliott got his 2nd in as many games. No thanks to another Ray Brooks assist. But this game finished 1-1 because of this absolute freak volley. I mean, it's just absolutely outstanding. How do you save that? What can you do about it? Playing against Valladolid next. A couple of changes to the starting lineup in this one. Marco Barella, I was singing his praises at the start of this video. Goes and gives away a penalty and gets a straight red card. Down to 10 men and 1-0 down. Not ideal, but nonetheless, we know how to play with 10 men. It's happened many times in this series. Riley Brooks throw on goal, has a half chance there, just bounces wide. Elliot should have put that in the back of the net. Then, in the second half, Rodrigo bangs that against the woodwork. Riley Brooks gets a tap in, very, very lucky. Kept on pushing for that second goal. Then, going into the final 4 minutes, Kukau, this other big Arborian striker, just drags that one wide. I probably should have brought on with Riviera. Going into stoppage time, unfortunately, we did concede again. Another loss, another bad loss. Not ideal. Wrong time of the season to be having losses like that. Up next on the road against Villarreal, Riley Brooks. Another fantastic goal for him. His season goes from strength to strength. Don't know about how I feel about that celebration. Bit of a weird one. Bit like our form, just stopping and starting at the minute. However, this game also finished 2-0. Pedro Azevedo, a goal and an assist in this one. Definitely stepping up to the mantle of replacing Yasuda in the middle of the park. On the road again against Bilbao next. Very, very tough away day this one, playing against the Basque side. Obviously, expecting this one to be quite a hard game. Fernando Calero, fantastic tackle there. Body on the line, brilliant block, saves a certain goal for sure. Manuel Figueroa also called into action, doing his defensive duties well. And then 17 minutes on the clock, Goat Lopez onto Azevedo, goes for goal from distance off the crossbar. Deserved a goal, really deserved a goal. Still 0-0 in the second half, doesn't happen very often. Harvey Elliott denied once again. And then Figueroa lobbed again from outside the box. It just doesn't stand on his line, what is he doing? Anyway, another loss. Now we're playing against Sevilla at home. Always fireworks in these games. Always. These games against Sevilla, always a cracker. Breton Diaz. I'm not going to call him Diaz. It's just Ben Breton, isn't he, really? He's just lied about that. Gave him a 2-0 lead inside the first 20. Should have grabbed one back. Rodrigo probably should have passed this. Goes for goal instead. Still 2-0. Harvey Elliott, again, trying to find the back of the net. Couldn't quite do it. Had to go all the way into the second half. Quite late on. Elliot Austin with an assist here. Elliot with a header. Dragging us over the line, bringing us back into the game. And then Rodrigo into Josh Johnson. Johnson gets himself his first goal of the season. God, we needed that. But unfortunately, once again, we've been done over by a late goal. 3-2 the final score. Second last game of the run-in, playing against Barcelona. A game that is full of emotion because we know RB Elliott next season will be wearing Barcelona colours. One lad, however, who will not be wearing Barcelona colours is Riley Brooks. His season goes from strength to strength once again, and he scores a great solo goal to put us 1-0 up. And then, out of nowhere, point to prove Rodrigo made it 2-0 inside the first half, getting some revenge on that disastrous away day we had earlier on the season. But then a moment of madness, give away another penalty, Marco Barella. De Bruyne steps up versus Figueroa, sends him the wrong way, grabs one back to Barcelona, and then a blink of an eye, Goretzka went and equalised. How have we thrown away another 2-0 lead? I don't know what keeps happening. Anyway, 9 minutes to go, this passage of play here. One of the greatest goals you will ever see in FIFA. Luis Muno's on the ball here. Takes his time, whips in a beautiful through ball. It's Riley Brooks with a scorpion kick. Yes, don't adjust your screens. That is a scorpion kick. A brace for Riley Brooks and 3 massive points in the bag against one of the biggest teams in the league. Oh, it's just absolutely phenomenal. Barcelona wondering if they bought the wrong English winger from our team. Absolutely beautiful. 3-2, 3 points. It's worth another replay. Oh, it's just gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. The first one I've ever scored. Absolutely unreal. Last game of the season, playing against Sociedad. Again, another team that beat us earlier on the season. Bit of rivalry in this one. Harvey Elliott, of course, making his final appearance for the club. So at the first 18 minutes, obviously Julian Brandt got himself a goal, putting 1-0 up. Going into the end of the first half, Rodrigo threatened from distance. Unfortunately, that one didn't find the back of the net. Figueroa called into action once again. Very, very nervy. However, this 10-pass move, absolutely glorious. Poetry in motion. Football at its highest quality. Nunes into Rodrigo, 1-1. He's not missing that, is he? 1-1. That's how this game finished. A point apiece. So, lads, that is the end of season 4. Let's see how we finished up and if we've done enough for European football. So, lads, there we are. We ended up remaining in 6th place all the way to the final day, and that is where we have finished up. A phenomenal season. Considering we were relegation scrapping last year and we've now achieved European football, we've done phenomenal. Looking at the player stats, Rodrigo picked up Golden Boot with 26, things you love to see. He also got top assists with 12. Elliot and Brooks also make the list. And then as well as that, Figueroa missed out on Golden Glove by 1 clean sheet. So brutally unlucky. Bit of transfer news. Helder Magellan, our mini Hulk, won't be coming back from loan. But of course, at the end of the season, it's time to welcome some new youth players. Only 2 are going to be joining up with the squad next season, one being Emmanuel Indri, Ivorian right back, 18 years old, got a little bit about him, could be a little warrior. As well as that, Valentin Caballero, finally found our Spanish technical player, 84 agility, 69 over already, could be a very tasty player in the middle of the park. As well as that, looking at the player stats overall, Juande, Calero, Rodrigo, Elliot played every minute of every game, of course they did. going to have to replace Harvey Elliott's 18 goals and 11 assists. And Rara Yasuda, 5-5. It's a lot of goals and assists to replace. Our transfer business is going to be absolutely crucial with what we do with that money to reinvest. Obviously, it's not the ideal scenario to have, especially having a good season, but I've got a plan. So I would normally leave the video here at the end of season four, but I don't feel like it's right not to show you what we're going to do with the Elliott money. So going into season five, of course, we've got a whole host of players going out on loan. Players like Valente, like Damien, like Johnson. Also, obviously, losing Yasuda, losing Elliott. Obviously, we've got a phenomenal amount of money. The board said 71 million, gave me a bit of a worry because obviously it should be a lot higher than that. I had to go look for myself. As I loaded it up, I was very, very nervous. But as you can see there, 255 million. We've basically got a blank check to work with this season. And I know exactly what I am doing. What three players are going to be joining up with Malaga? Lads, it is time to welcome the return of the King. Yes, that is right, lads. Roberto is joining us once again. Brought him back from Germany. 48 million, 40k a week. It's a massive transfer, a club record transfer, in fact. He left us the boy. He's returning as a man, 23 years old, 85 overall. That there is a quality bit of business. And obviously, he ticks our quota of being from the academy. As well as that, he wasn't the only player making a shock return. David Larrivia, our original number eight, 44 million from Brentford, 23-year-old, 81 overall, is going to be joining up with us. As well as that, Pablo Fornal, 22.5 mil, another player from the academy. So those three will be going straight into the starting 11. We're going to make a change of system just so we can get Roberto and Rodrigo into the starting lineup. I've got to play both of them. It's a mouth-watering partnership. It could be one of the best partnerships we've ever seen. But of course, going to take time for the boys to adjust and settle. Change of system as well. Going to be playing in Europa League as well, don't forget. So squad depth will be tested. So lads, that is where we're going to wrap up this video on the eve of season 5. I hope you did enjoy it. If you did, make sure that like button and subscribe if you are new. Helps me out, lets you know that you guys are enjoying this kind of content. I will keep getting the videos out as quickly as possible. There's still one a week. Lads, I thank you very much for watching. Oh, that scorpion kick's so outrageous. I thank you for watching and I will see you in the next video. Cheers.